Australia to sunny Berlin.
Yeah.
We are here from the local TV station called the Open Channel. First of all, maybe as you have problems with your drummer and guitarist, maybe you explain how you got them and who they are.
All right. Our first drummer, we killed him with an axe, and our next drummer, we killed him with an axe, and our third drummer, we're going to kill him with an axe, but we haven't told him yet.
I did not expect anyone anything else. Your CD is called Fuck You, We're Death.
Yeah.
But as I can see, you're not death.
No, we are fucked.
Yeah.
We're not death, we are fucked.
Would you define your music as death metal?
No, shit. Crap. Rubbish. Bullshit.
You're playing technically very brilliant and high-speed metal. So why do you use this stage show, which is not necessary, really, because you're playing such good music?
What stage show?
I think we're expecting a stage show tonight.
Oh, from us?
Yeah.
Oh, we don't really do much on stage. We just play music and spit and like tip beer over our heads and stuff.
Oh, that's quite okay. Something we would like to know, Australia so far, and we think it's very conservative. Is there a metal scene at all? And are there fanzines? I know only Armored Angel, for example, and Bestia Warlust. What's the scene there?
I mean, it's just like over here, I've noticed it's the same thing. In Australia, it's like there's millions of bands, but they're all shit. They're all like... In Australia, all the bands are copying of what's happening in Europe or America.
Mm.
They're not coming up with their own stuff in Australia. There's no original bands. Like, they either copy, like, Darkthrone or maybe Sepultura or something like this. They're just copying all the time.
Mm.
But we just do our own shit. I mean, it's impossible to be totally original, because the only way you can be totally original if you chop your arm off and stick it on your head and like smoke cigarettes through your eyes or something. That's being original.
Yeah, that brings me to another problem. Lord Hardis, Reverend Hardis, always has these pins in the arms.
Yes.
As you can see on here. Does he still do it? Does it hurt, or is he used to it?
No. It doesn't hurt him. He's got scars all up and down his arms, though.
Mm.
He does, not every show he does that, but say about half the shows, yeah.
Then I have a personal question. You have a song there called The Astral Abortus. First of all, how did you come to this name? And secondly, more important, how will you do it in practice?
Okay. That song, our bass player, Dave Slavey, writes most of the music. He came up with that and he had lyrics. It was about, originally the lyrics were about like wanking. And like when you wank, what happens to the sperm? Where does that go? It's being aborted. Like, I don't understand these lyrics or anything.
Yeah.
Exactly. But in that song, now, it's called Astral Abortus, but it hasn't really got lyrics. Most of it's just made up bullshit. Like, just crap, you know? But it's got some words like, fuck you all, die, we are fucked, and all this sort of shit. We are fucking mental, fuck off, all that sort of shit.
I see.
But it doesn't really mean anything.
It brings me to the next question. Dave said, your music is the ultimate brain destruction and Armageddon mayhem. So whose brain destruction is it? From the band or the spectators?
Well, if anybody gets in the way, in Australia we got these bits of wood called lumber 4x2, like 4 inches by 2 inches. And in Australia you go to the hardware store and you buy this piece of wood. It's like if anybody thinks that you're fucked, you bash them over the head with a lump of 4x2. That's brain destruction.
I see, that's quite obvious. So I think I better leave you to your beer now, and thank you for the interview.